Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller with Eyes on the Sky. 10 years ago, I did a video for the very first time on YouTube, and it was how to align an equatorial mount. And while that video is still accurate, I have gotten a lot of questions over the years about how to aim the telescope at the celestial pole without having to be able to see the celestial pole. So if you either can't see Polaris in the northern hemisphere, or if you're in the southern hemisphere and you are trying to align towards Sigma Octans, which is a very dim star, it's only fifth magnitude, then how do you do that? Or what if you have a tree in the way? Or a building, or some other structure where you're unable to be able to physically see where the celestial pole is at. So this video is designed to help you do that and do it quickly. So here's how we kind of start with that. You do need one piece of equipment, and that's going to be a decent compass. And what the compass is going to be able to do, it's going to help you set the telescope in the right direction. And we'll kind of need to do sort of two things at once. We're going to need to both level the telescope as well as align it. So you might have to do a little bit of one and the other, but we'll start by aiming this. You can see I'm actually on uneven ground here. So we need to make sure that we're using our legs to accurately get things set up. Now, one thing about a compass, when you're using it near something like iron, the problem is that it can mess up the compass and cause it to give an inaccurate reading. So what I do is I just use a little piece of wood, and then you can hold that right on there and then parallel, and you're gonna get a much better reading. Now, I'm not anywhere close to being north. North is kind of this way from where I'm at. So what we wanna do is have the counterweights facing towards the north. So I'm literally just gonna pick up the mount and spin it around, because on this particular mount, I cannot actually spin it very far. It's just got a limited movement to be able to do that. So we'll get this all set up. There, and that's pretty close. It's not dead on, but it's close enough that I'll be able to use the fine adjustment. So now what I wanna do is actually level the telescope. And there's a bubble level on this particular mount, so that helps me to level it. If you don't have that, there's a couple different ways you can do that. One is you can use a plumb line, which is just a weight with a string on it, and you can actually hold that right underneath the center of the telescope here and have it drop down right in the middle of where your tray is, and if that's centered, then you'll be all set. And just like that, I've got a good level with my bubble level here. We need to make sure that we are aimed in the correct direction. So I'm gonna pull these open like this, give myself plenty of room. That way I can spin the mount like this. I'll bring my compass back out. Now, the thing that you need to know about a compass is that magnetic north is not the same as true north. So while I have this aimed directly at magnetic north right now, my actual location from where I am is about 4 degrees off of true north. So I need to adjust for that. And then I can use these to even refine that just a little bit further if I need to. And then also lock it into place so that it won't move during my observing or astrophotography session. And that's pretty good. That has me at magnetic north, but I have adjusted where my actual north is. You can see this is a really good compass because it allows me to move this and has a nice sharp line right there showing where I'm at, and I'm 4 degrees off of north. So when it aims north on the compass itself, I can account and adjust for that. So that gets me at true north. Now I need to look at what my actual latitude is. So we can find that with a simple Google search or using your favorite search engine to find out what your actual latitude is. You want to get that within a degree is really going to be ideal. Most telescope mounts only provide at best about every 2 degrees. And with this particular telescope, you can even see the arrow is a flat looking arrow from how it was actually made when it was cast. So that's not terribly accurate necessarily. So in order to adjust that, we want to take our slow motions here, and you can see I can move this down this way. If I was closer towards the equator, I would be able to move it this direction. So with this, I'm, you know, closer to like 32 degrees, and then if we want to crank that up, we can move that up as well. If you happen to be in either the northern part of the United States or in Canada or even in the United Kingdom, then you would want this quite a bit further, and it would need to be more like this, up more towards maybe 50 or 55, or even if you're north of there, you can bring that all the way up as well. So I'm at 41 degrees north latitude. So what I wanna do is try to look at this and get it as close as I possibly can, because I know I'm facing north. So if I get it as close as I can to that 41, and that's gonna put me right between the 40 and the 42 mark, that should be pretty close. And then I wanna lock this one on this side. And now I'm locked here, so I cannot move left to right relative to what the celestial pole is. And now I also have my latitude correct, because the latitude that I have this set at is going to be parallel to the axis of the Earth, how it rotates. So when you're parallel with that, then you can turn your telescope in right ascension and declination, and then it will follow the stars depending on which direction that you have your telescope pointed. Now you can see that this is not balanced. So that's what we're going to do next. So this is really, really off. And the reason why you want to balance the telescope is because it's helpful to be able to unlock those clutches. This is your right ascension clutch, because that's that axis right here that aims towards the pole. And in declination, you want to be able to aim the telescope whatever you want to try to look at without having to touch it, because you're going to want to be able to move that mount to aim precisely at what you want to see. And then once you've done that, you will be able to then relock the clutches, engage your motor drives, and then have your mount automatically track the night sky. Not every mount has the automatic motor drive. Some of them may just have a slow motion control. And even if that's the case, then really you just follow the sky just by slowly turning that. So let's see how our balance is. So if we move this, that's still a little off. So I need to move that up. And that looks pretty good in right ascension. So that's not gonna move at all. Now you know, may have noticed that I actually go ahead and mark these, because it's so much easier in the dark to have even just a simple knowing which right ascension and which one goes to declination. You don't need to mark both, but even just one, then you know that the other one goes into the other location. So we also need to get ourselves set in declination. Now, for this particular telescope, I'm at a bit of a disadvantage, and I need to change this somewhat, because even though this looks like it's balanced, it actually is a little bit tail heavy, and I also need to still put a star diagonal and an eyepiece on there. So that's really gonna make it heavy on that end, because I also have a finder scope there, but I can't move this any further. So I actually need a longer dovetail mount that I can move this further back this direction, so I can balance the telescope more, because I've run out of space to be able to lock this into place. So once we have that all set, then we can lock everything into place. And then you will be aligned at the celestial pole, and then you'll be able to aim them out wherever you want to go. So if you want to look at something that's towards the celestial pole, you can do this. If you want something that's maybe more towards the celestial equator, you do this. Now, if you're going on that side of the sky, don't do this. You don't want your counterweight up. Do a meridian flip, flip it around, and then aim it that way. And it's just as simple as that. And that's how you align an equatorial mount without having to see the celestial pole. And then you're all set to be able to observe the sky and only have to turn it in one direction for an axis, or turn on the motor drive and let it go. I want to thank you for checking out this video and sticking with me for the last 10 years. I've been making videos on how to find all kinds of amazing things in the night sky. We've looked at solar eclipses, we've looked at lunar eclipses, we've looked at comets, we've seen all the planets, including Pluto. Yes, Pluto, you're still a planet. We've looked at all kinds of deep sky objects and double stars and a lot of amazing things to be able to see in the night sky. And I hope you'll continue that journey with me. I'll keep helping you find amazing things, and I'll help you learn how to use your equipment to the maximum potential so that you can see that too. Thanks for watching. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.
What are you doing?
What?
Hey. Are you trying to see the stars and the moon better?
Yes.
Maybe try something different. You have the hedge trimmers.